Hey, welcome, welcome. We're gonna do a little more service on my Ford Ranger here. It's getting close to 100,000. I traded my little Aveo for it here a couple of months ago, and I like to change out all the fluids at 100,000. I think it's got about 98 something on it now, but rather than do it all at once, I thought I'd do it a little at a time. Today we're going to change the transmission fluid here. Now this is a Merco V or 5. I got 5 quarts there. Now I have read everything, watched everybody else's videos on the automatic transmission, and everybody seems to have a different point of view, but after studying all of it, I've decided to use this device here. I got it off of eBay. It sucks the fluid out through the fill line. That was $36 shipping and all through eBay. And I just got CarQuest transmission fluid because Motorcraft, they didn't have it around where I was at, and I had to order it, and it's about twice as much money. And from what I can tell there, as long as you use the correct kind for the vehicle, you know, and since I'm not going to completely flush the transmission, what I'm going to do, the service manual here says to change it at 150,000 miles to change the filter and the fluid. Of course, you have to flush one to change the fluid. And from what I can tell, everybody says that, you know, it could mess the transmission up and all this. So my idea, this is just my idea, and a few other people I know on YouTube do the same thing. I'm just going to pump it out through the dipstick, refill it, and then I'm going to, every time I change the oil, I'm going to pump out a quart or two or something other and change it. And then at 150,000, which it's going to take me a pretty good while to ever get that on there, if I still got the truck, then I might consider dropping the pan and changing the filter. That's what I'm going to do. So, let's get started. Okay, let's start with this suction pump here. It looks like we got all different kinds of size lines. And in fact, this one plugs in this spot here, and then we find a line that will fit down in the fill tube. So it's got two here I won't need. This just pushes in here like this. Dipstick. Pull the dipstick out. Fluid looks okay in it. This car is pretty, truck's pretty clean. Now let's see, where can we put this? Like it's going to have to be raised up quite a bit to I'll have to get something to set this on, I believe. could plug two of them together.
Let's try that.
Well, this one doesn't hook onto that. It just leaves it small. Looks like it might be too small. Well, they don't push on there either, so I guess you just have to use the two. Like I said, I haven't done this before. I'm trying to push that back down in there again. Seems to go so far and stop. Maybe you're supposed to use the small one. Put it on there. It's awfully small though. It's extremely small. Just keep pulling apart with it. Okay. I needed a little clamp to clamp the second hose on her. So I wound up putting it up here like this. And the oil's coming up. Let's see if it'll work this way. Do this again, I'm gonna get a little clamp to clamp it on with. So I had to use the biggest hose to go into the pump, and I had to use the next size to go down in the fill. Well, not the next size, the next smallest size. It wouldn't go all the way down in there. I don't know why you can hear it or not, but you can hear it. The oil coming up. Now this container is measured off in these lines on the side are a quart. Making sure you could see what I was doing. Time I push down on it, you can see oil and hear it go in. The fluid, I'm calling it oil, but transmission fluid. Yeah, some little clamps on those hoses would have been good. Didn't say anything about that in the instructions. Would have been down on the floor, you could have seen how much it was you were taking out. Being on the slant like this, it's kind of hard to looks like I may just took this long to get just about a quart out. More than a quart out of it. I'm gonna stop you so you don't have to just watch that. Okay, I've got 4 quarts out of it, and it's sucking air now. 4 quarts, and I'm going by the lines here. But it's, you can hear it, it's sucking air. It probably took me about 10-15 minutes. It'd been a lot easier if this pump had been on the ground. The truck holds almost 10 quarts. So you can see there's still a whole lot in the transmission in the torque converter. Still coming out. It's just not a solid stream. It's a lot of air bubbles. Thinking about stopping at 4. Because I'm not going to get it all out anyway. It's hard to tell when it's on exactly 4 and it leaned up like this. Stop there at 4. Okay. Take this one out of the top and lift this out so you can see it there. And it's just shy of 4 quarts. Just shy of 4 quarts. said, I was using the largest line and the next to the smallest line. Get this out, and I'm getting all fluid all over. I keep saying all fluid all over. So there's what I was using. Now, if I had a clamp to have clamped this on the next smallest one from the largest one, it probably wouldn't have took as long, but I was out of the clamps. Okay, let me lay this over here. Okay, a little shy of 4 quarts. Okay. I'm gonna start out trying to use this. This is the funnel I use on the Prius to put the transmission fluid in here. It went down in the pipe a pretty good ways. I've got several different funnels, I'm gonna try this one because I can stand out here with it and maybe pour it in. Okay. Goes. Like I said, this is the first time I've ever done this. I've changed it on the Prius, but it's kind of a different thing. This fluid's a lot cleaner. Going in pretty good. And I plan on every time I change oil, I'll pull out 2 to 4 quarts and change it. And I don't know how that works out. You know, a lot of cars, they say you don't ever have to change it. But I think at 100,000 miles, you need to do something. I know on the Prius, I've changed it every 60,000. And my little Chevrolet Aveo, I changed it every 60,000 miles. So, unusual smell to it. It's going in fast. And like I said, I don't drive this truck a lot, so I'm thinking maybe that I won't ever have to worry about the transmission if I do this. Now here's 3 quarts. And I took out just shy of 4. This is the same fluid that's used in the power steering, so I'll probably just change it too. I kind of wished I'd have just kept letting it suck there a little longer. And I made it even 4 quarts, but if it had been sitting on the floor, I could have told what I was doing. But I cocked up there in the engine like that. Now this one, it doesn't hardly take a quart. Well, this is just 3. No, that's 4. This is the 4th one. So I need to stop here. I'll stop it there. And if it's a little low, I can finish topping it off after I've started and run it. Okay. Lift this up, let it all run in there. Okey-dokey. Alright. Stick in there. Of course, I'll have to start it up and put it in gear. According to this, it looks all right. Looks cleaner and redder. But that's 4 quarts out of almost 10. But it's got to help. Okay, here is the power steering. It uses the same fluid the transmission does. So I'm going to see if I can suck it out and change it since I got the fluid. That wouldn't reach, but it don't. Whoops. Okay, now I got a pump down here on the ground. There it goes. It doesn't take as long to suck it out. Okay. Get that sucked out. Alright. Move this back out of the way. Got 5 quarts. 5 quarts of this transmission fluid. I think it's about $36 tax and all from Advance. Funky smell. tip, like about half of a quart. Half of a quart. We'll set this one over here somewhere else and keep that other one. So I'll know how much I like putting it in there. See here. Slip back on here. Wipe her off. Transmission fluid changed and the power steering fluid changed. Okie dokie. Check my oil. I hadn't checked it since I changed the truck. It looks full. Like I say, I'm doing 100,000 mile service on it. But I'm just doing a little bit of it at a time so I can show y'all what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. Okay. Okay, we've got a couple of little toys I bought off of eBay here. I got a phone holder that goes in your CD player. I don't ever use a CD player, but I need somewhere to put my phone. And I saw this over at Walmart. They were like $24 at Walmart. Went on eBay and I got this one and also one for the Prius for $5.50 total. Slips in your CD player. You pull this back here, put it in your CD player, and then lock it down. I also got, I had an empty spot in the dash, looked like where a cigarette lighter goes, but I already had a cigarette lighter, so I don't know what went there before. So I found this little USB that goes in a cigarette lighter. I thought I'd see if it might fill that slot up. Right now I've got just an extra cigarette lighter in it, which I don't use. And this one was supposed to fit flush. See? So we'll got a little carbon. Now that I can use. These two little toys. This was around $3 or something like that for this. Okay, let's move around here and see if these will work. Okay, maybe you can see there. Let's see, I had two cigarette lighters here. This one didn't have nothing in it when I got the truck, and they both look like cigarette lighters. So I bought this USB. See if it'll go in there. See how? Yeah, that's pretty good. It even lights up. At least it's different. And then this phone holder, it goes in your CD player. It has little spacers here in another pack. I reckon you get one that's the thickness you need. It'll tighten up real tight. I already put one in the Prius, and that's why we had to do on here. Yeah, if I can get the package undone here. But I think CD players are a thing of the past myself. Of course, I could get an Android radio and put in here, but I'm 71 years old. Stuff like that don't mean a whole lot to me anymore. And I sure ain't gonna haul around a bunch of CDs falling all over the place. I always thought that was stupid anyway. Okay. This little spacer goes right over this. It's got a number on it, I guess, for the size. And then you put it in there like that. And you pull that clip up. Okay, that seems pretty good. And then you adjust this for your phone. That's pretty neat, I guess. Like I said, that was $5.50 on eBay, and this little dude was about $3. But I can use that CD player. I'll never use it. To me, just the radios is enough. Okay, let's start the truck up after we change the fluid and see how it starts up. I'll never leave the key in it because I found out that if you leave the key in one, it will run the battery down. At least it did on the Aveo. Okay. Got it in neutral. I'm gonna go out just for the heck of it and check the transmission fluid with it in idle. With it in neutral, the transmission, it was between completely full, you know, the little checkered lines, and the low, or add. So that's okay. I'll drive it for a little while, and I may put that other part of the cord in there. Okay. Okay, that's it for this time. And we got a few more things to for the 100,000 mile tune-up on this. So thanks for watching. Please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, because I'm always doing something, always something different. And thanks again for watching.